What the fucking... Okay. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Far Cry New Dawn. One memento, as I need to go to my roster, and I need to get rid of you. I'm sorry, Pastor Jerome. Not today, Sonny Jim. But I would like to take this moment to first check what that Discord message is, because it's important right now. But I would like to take this moment to explain a handful of things. Okay, that's more like it, friends. That's more like it. Slap me. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Slap my waifu. Okay, so anyways, continuing on. I would like to point out a couple things here first that I either neglected to mention in the first session and as to why we're only just now getting to the second session and what that means. So first of all, I'd like to point out that in the description below, I did not mention this, but I have linked all of my previous Far Cry Let's Plays. That's Far Cry 3 Ziggy's Mod, Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon, Far Cry 4 Blind, Blood Dragon was also blind, Far Cry 4 Amida, Far Cry 4 Escape from Dergesh Blind, Far Cry 4 Valley of the Yeti Blind, there is also some Far Cry 4 co-op in there, Far Cry Primal Blind, Far Cry 5 Blind, Far Cry 5 Hours of Darkness Blind, and Far Cry 5 Mars, Lost on Mars Blind. I don't have the Far Cry 5 Zombie stuff because I haven't actually played it, nor have I finished the Escape from Mars stuff either, which I will probably finish sometime after this LP here. I just wanted to point that out because, well, obviously it's something that normally I would point out in case you're interested in watching my other Far Cry stuff. Then I would also like to point out that it's been a couple days since this game released, and I didn't play it as much as I said I was going to be. Well, there's a couple reasons. Reason number one is that I obviously have been doing a butt ton of stuff on the Discord server with everybody playing War Thunder and stuff like that, and in just about a day and a half, there is going to be a War Thunder event, marathon event, that's going to last about 18 days until I can finish it. This same exact thing happened when Far Cry 5 released, if you remember. Far Cry 5 released, we played it a butt ton, and then a couple days after it released, War Thunder had some April Fool-style events and a tournament event. Or not a tournament, but a semi-tournament sort of style event, and I was unable to play for very long for a couple days. That's pretty much what's going to be happening again, and I just wanted to make this quick session here to give you guys a heads up as to that's why New Dawn probably will be not played that often over the course of the next couple weeks. I'll try to get some sessions in here and there after I'm done with War Thunder tasks each day, we'll have to see. And also right now, this session is not going to be that long either, because I'm currently waiting for a message on Discord of somebody who's going to log on, and then we're going to squat up in War Thunder again. So, yeah. So, just wanted to give you guys that heads up so you know what's going on. So, I apologize about that, the fact that I haven't played much in the recent day. But other than that, that's a turkey. We're going to continue. So, these are friendlies over here, I would hope. No, they're not. Okay, let's take these guys down then. So, we'll have to take a look at my map and see exactly what we can do. We might just do, like, some scavenging stuff. Not really do anything mission-related. Don't spot me. Somebody else is about to spot me. Make piñatas! I'll make your armpit. Nah, I won't finish that. I was gonna say something pretty nasty. Okay.
Gonna live another day, thanks to you.
Alright. Okay, so, yeah. Last time we helped Pastor Jerome. Here at Nick's old flight place. Memories to Far Cry 5. It's kind of neat. Okay, so let's take a look at our map. Actually, let's take a look at our perks, because we've got 7 available points. I have a cup of chocolate milk. You know the last time I had chocolate milk, guys? It was like... I don't know when. It was like back before I even started doing Mass Effect. Yeah, it's been a while. Oh my god. Oh. Yes. It tastes so good. Okay, anyways, let's have a look here. So, heavily armed. So this will allow me to carry fourth weapon. We're gonna get that right now. bam. So we've got 3 points left. What do we want? As a fishing rod to your weapon wheel, so we can fish, I guess. Skydiver, I don't know if I really want that right now. Increase fist and kick damage, that could be useful. But I like the idea of ammo. We haven't really run low on ammo yet, though, to be honest. More med kits would be nice, of course. So we could go for... Well, how much ammo do we get here? 70 rounds? Oh shit, hold on. We got something else to do. Fuck, who put this giant ass fence in the way? What? Is this the guy that's gonna get the thing? Excuse me. Okay. Yeah. They got there before me. Let's get in and get out before anybody else shows up. Alright. Now let's check our map. And let's see. Yeah. So we've got some stuff scattered around. We need to buy more of those maps so that we can see more locations. Nick? Nick's alive? He doesn't have... I guess maybe we're not close enough. I thought Nick died. At least it was implied that he's dead. Yes, by the way, one of the things that I got wrong was the fact that I assumed that Nick... was actually dead at the end of Far Cry 5, as in he was in the vehicle with us. But in the comments section, it's actually you and the other law enforcement members along with Joseph and not Nick. So Nick and all the other characters that were there ran off, I guess, into one of the other vehicles or something. Or at least you could assume that that's what they did. I cannot. I suck at driving vehicles in this game. What the fuck? Okay, let's cross this beautiful blue water. Like, this looks like blue cream soda right here. I would drink all of it. I'd drink it until it popped. Either that was a bug that just flew by, or that was a distant goat. I see, I don't want one of these bikes. I want a vehicular. Like an actual vehicular. We should get on the road then. And perhaps I can strike something that comes down. Better not use that weapon. So I'll probably put like either an explosive weapon or a shotgun or something in this slot. We'll have to see. Because, I mean, the bow was nice, but I don't know if I'm going to really enjoy the bow in a game like this where enemies are a little bit more spongy. No mushroom or ethanol or aerosol can give me as much of a rush as watching that train crash. Because, I'll be honest, I know that in some of the previous, Far Cry games, you know, some enemies could feel a little spongy, like the heavy enemies and stuff. But generally, it always followed the same rule, right? You know, but in here, you've noticed with my assault rifle and stuff, even some of the basic enemies, I have to sit there and pump a few rounds into before I even knock them down to close to being killed. Which is not a complaint. Like I said, that's perfectly fine as long as it just stays within the spin-off thing and not carry over into other Far Cry mainline titles. But because of that, I feel like some weapons just aren't as fun for me to use, like the bow.
The highwaymen have got trucks loaded with a variety of loot and crafting materials.
Oh.
See if you can pick them off. Could make for a big score.
Well, thank you for telling me that after the truck passed by, because I thought it was just an ordinary truck. Okay, this guy's got an ATV. The fuck was that noise? Is that human? Is that Bigfoot out there? I'm getting the fuck out of here. Screw that shit. Oh, wait, hold on a minute. Let me go into options, because there was something on the Steam review section. Hold on. That I read. I don't know if it's in this, but there was a mode. Aha! Streamer mode. I can turn off all licensed music. Which is good for people that record for YouTube and or stream and stuff. Which, really? Streaming? I mean, I guess, but do you know how many fucking streams I've seen? Like, I don't watch streams, but you know how many streams I've, like, logged into for a few seconds or seen clips of on YouTube that are just playing constant licensed music? Is it... I didn't think streaming was as, like, strict as uploading to something like YouTube was when it came to licensed music, but... Oh, it's this little place. At least I think this is the same place from Far Cry 5. Where you have to save a couple people. Could be a different one, actually. Okay, let's... So there are three components here. And some frame drops. Resistance note. So fucking dark and cold. I'd like to see the sun again. Fought Joseph Seed for nothing. Maybe this is what I deserve. So he was one of the friendlies. I hear people all of a sudden. There's a pink flower pointing through the wall there. Okay, I do want to point this out, because this was one of my complaints with Far Cry 5. You see how I'm crouched here? Do you see the FOV of the weapon? See how it's like up in front, and it's direct? It all makes sense. But when I stand up, it's like off the screen. It's same like when I'm holding onto his assault rifle. See how he's holding it down, or she's holding it down, lower, and up? Little more realistic, honestly, considering that she's supposed to be hip-firing here, even though it looks like she's clearly holding it in front of her face. But that was one of the bigger complaints that a lot of people had, or minor nitpicks a lot of people had with Far Cry 5, was that it just didn't look as meaningful because your gun was off the screen. And I feel that same way. They obviously carried that over with this. But I hope that they kind of change that or give us an option to change that in some of the future Far Cry titles, because I'd rather have the weapon on the screen. I know that's not for everybody, because people are going to want... to be able to see more of their screen than have it blocked by a weapon, but I'm not necessarily the same way unless it's overly ridiculous like Borderlands. Okay, I bet the other component is... Oh no, we found the component. Wait, what? When did we find the component? I looted the snake. Okay. Alright. Well, we're near the safe place, right? Because I don't remember exactly what you need to do to purchase the maps. So I should probably head that way and see quick. This might be a complete waste of time, but what is this place? This was where Tweak was, right? Or whatever his name was. Bean. I said Tweak. That's the guy from Far Cry 5. Bean. Components sitting here. Don't mind if I do. Fuck. Okay, this will last not long at all. Holy shit. So I saw a lot of people on Steam when it comes to negative reviews. Not really complaining about the game, but complaining about the length. It is a spin-off title, so of course it's going to be short. But some of these hours people were talking about finishing it, beating it, and one person stated that they beat it in 3 hours, and then they were done, and that's all they had on their Steam record. And then they were done playing it. I mean, maybe if you just rush the story, you'll do it in 3 hours. But nobody has to, nor should they be expected to have to sit, you know, and be forced to play a game to full 100% completion. But if you're going to buy a game like this and then beat it in 3 hours and complain about it, you're obviously rushing something, at least in my opinion. Maybe I'm the only one that feels that way. But still, 3 hours just seems a little ridiculous. Short game or not. I mean, hell, Call of Duty games aren't even that short sometimes. Somebody else said that it took them about 10 to 16 hours. Now that sounds a lot more believable. That sounds like they not only did the story, but they did some of the side stuff, maybe all of it, you know, did some exploration. They didn't just rush through every single story mission right away on the easiest difficulty. Again, you're not intended to play on the hardest difficulty either, but if you play the easiest difficulty and rush the entire story and then complain about it, I think you have nobody but yourself to blame for that. And I know I've ranted about this in all of the other Far Cry LPs I've done, but it still stands in my opinion. Okay, so we're back. Let me go see about these maps. I can upgrade it. Let me see. So, can we buy MIPS? Yeah, so we can't buy MIPS. We have to, resource, reveal stashes for springs, gears. Yeah, so we have components and those things. Okay, so we just need level 1. So I should be able to spend a little bit of ethanol. And is this actually going to visually upgrade it? Because if it does... I don't know, because I didn't look inside. But they do a cutscene, so they act like it...
Friends dying in the train.
They act like it visually upgraded itself. And if that's the case, I love that. Because I just like having the little progression sort of things. Do we have any loot to trade? We do. Let's go ahead and trade that all. Get some stuff for it. Okay, intel maps. Let's go ahead. It's going to cost us quite a bit of ethanol, but I'm going to want this stuff. So buy with ethanol. And buy with ethanol. So we've unlocked springs and gear stashes on maps. And we'll have to level up even more to unlock the other stuff. Well, we've got more stuff. Birds. Eagle and duck. Duck is new. I don't think there was duck in any other Far Cry game. At least huntable duck. Elk, caribou, bison, wild bull, pronghorn. I don't know what a pronghorn is. White-tailed deer. Pronghorn, the second fastest land animal, and wild boar. And then, of course, fish. All of this stuff costs ethanol. It's very cheap, but monstrous animal. Monstrous bear, boar. Are these just like the predators? Oh, no, the... Oh, God. Okay, I don't know what a monstrous one is. That kind of scares me a little bit. I don't think we need to go buying that stuff right now. I'm not fancying... Okay, we could upgrade this. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Yeah, again, I didn't pay attention to see if anything actually updated. It looks maybe a little cleaner. There's some loot here now, some gears.
I'm glad my girl Clarkar is back. Doesn't matter, she only brought...
Okay, so we can now make rank 2 weaponry. Let's see. Some stuff in here that's all nice. I still don't know if you can customize this stuff or not. I didn't even see any complaints on Steam. So, I mean, whatever. I can accept it since it's a spin-off title. Like, if this was a mainline Far Cry game and you couldn't customize, there'd be a big problem. The RPG's kind of interesting. Now let's look at rank 2 quick. Yeah, see. We could get ourselves a stealth pistol, I guess. Makeshift. I like the P226 in Far Cry 5. It's a fun gun. Oh! We gotta get this! Oh, this is what titanium is used for, the bigger guns. Look at this! Look how expensive it is! We've been collecting so much stuff and we barely even have enough gears and titanium to afford just one gun. That's not a complaint either, I like that. The MP40? Fuck! I don't have enough duct tape! Of course, screw you, Ubisoft. Shotguns, I do not want anything that looks as ugly as that. That might get... We can get this? We need more duct tape. We can get the AK-47 already? Already? What? Oh, shit. Well, I don't want to jump right into the big boy guns. So, I think we could craft the MP34 and let's compare that to the ACR. Or the ARC, rather. I don't know what... Is the green a buff in the MP40 department? Makeshift MP40. Yeah, so the MP34... I said MP40. The MP34 has higher damage. Lower RPM. A whopping extra 2 rounds in the magazine. But it's automatically better than the ARC because it's World War II. Or it's probably pre-World War II, but, you know, you get what I'm trying to say. Well, MP34, maybe 1934 is when it was developed. Could be wrong on that, you know, correct me if I am. Oh, that was a Discord thing, let me check that quick. But I'm probably going to get this and replace my ARC with it. No, I was pinged on the Discord server. Somebody pinged me about the Leningrad dev blog. Doing new dawn. Not important. Somebody thought it was funny that I had just started my LP or started LPing and then I'd have to stop and go do a dev blog, but I just posted on the Discord that it's not important enough, the Leningrad Destroyer, to warrant me stopping my LP. It's not. If it was like a new rank 7 or rank 6 or rank 7 ground vehicle, then yeah, I would have stopped. But okay, well, see, here's the thing. Do I get the MP34 now, or do I get something to put in my fourth slot? Although the MP34, is that considered a submachine gun? Because it might not use the same ammunition as the ARC. Let me see. So ARC is an assault rifle, and the MP34 should be a submachine gun. Yeah, so this will use submachine gun ammo, which means that my MAC is also an SMG, which is a problem. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to get the MP34 craft with materials, and we're going to put that there. So sorry, ARC. We don't need two assault style weapons or automatics. And then we are going to, we're just going to, fuck it. We're going to bring our 1911 back, and then I need to collect more resources to be able to get like a shotgun or something. I want an LMG, because of course we are going to have fucking... I mean, this is going to replace our MP34 once I get enough resources again. So that should be simple enough there. And I want an LMG, because LMGs I never use enough in Far Cry games, except the MG42. And these guys will probably dish out a ton of damage in this game. And of course, I want the fucking MG42 really bad. That's one of the elite weapons. So I can't get that until many years down the road. I'll probably get this as my new secondary, but I need to collect some gears. So let's go out and let's do some resource collecting.
More than zero, last I checked.
Oh, somebody's got a side mission for us.
Keeping up with your career, Herc's telling everyone he's on a path of vengeance. I don't know what he's talking about, but I do know that he's good in a fight.
How the fuck?
I saw him chasing a group of highwaymen near a cave down that way.
How the fuck?
You go introduce yourself.
Does Herc keep surviving everything? Okay. Oh, this isn't where we get our vehicles. We could probably use that club vehicle, that blueprint one. Oh, nice. Okay, this looks pretty badass. I like this. I like the look of this gun. Post-apocalyptic. It's got fucking batteries. Do you see that? Because of the red dot sight, which is I would assume that that's because of the red dot sight. They have it being charged with fucking built-in batteries. That is hilarious. Okay, now. Land vehicles. Let me see here. Here, club. Yes. Yeah. Oh, that's an interesting looking vehicle. Get me in there. Okay, let's take a look at our map and see if anywhere new has opened up now that we bought some more mips. Yeah, some new stuff. Oh, there's a deer photograph that we must have passed by and missed. Well, that's closest. So we can get that. Now it looks like we might need to head north. There's a going haywire there. Well, let's go get that photograph first. Oh no! Oh, it still sounds as badass. Oh, they said they did such a good job with the gun sounds in Far Cry 5. Challenge completed. Deer season. We have 4 perk points. I should probably start investing in this stuff here, so. Light ammo of handguns, SMG. Yeah, let's. Let's do that. I'll get some extra SMG ammo. Oh, I fucking killed. I did exactly what I would sometimes do in Far Cry 5. I ended up killing the civilian that was in the back. Oh, that's sucky. That's sucky a lotty. Oh shit, are those enemies coming? Could have gone better. Who else to see me? Oh yeah, we got some people. Not today, Sonny Jims. Was there not 2 of them that I killed here? Okay, one of them poofed. Thanks, Thanos. 1,000 words. Find all the locations. Well, we found one of them. Tracy's Travels. Hold Z to draw out the photo. Yeah, that's what this used to look like here. Right, so I guess we have all the photos and we just have to go around to the various locations. That was kind of cool. Yeah, so one of the things that somebody sent me a message about was using the binoculars to get fancy looking screenshots for my thumbnails, like I kind of did in Far Cry 5. But there doesn't seem to be binoculars or a camera in this game. Like in the previous games, Far Cry games, it's usually been a staple camera, right, that you pull out and you could remove the HUD and stuff. Which it would make sense if you don't have a camera in this, because it is post-apocalyptic. There's a photo mode right here. Okay, I guess that's what you're intended to use. But maybe there is one that you can bring up. I just have to go into the options menu to find it. Okay, so now I want to head Barack Obama this way. So another thing I should probably point out is, when I was taking down that outpost, remember I said I wish that there was a Far Cry game with a desert in it, because we haven't had deserts yet? Somebody said, jokingly, you know, Far Cry 2, am I a joke to you? Far Cry 2 doesn't count in my opinion. First of all, because I was mainly talking about... Oh, this is really gonna hurt. Fuck, I didn't put it into... Anyways, mainly I was talking about the Far Cry formula games, which started with Far Cry 3. Then, of course, each of the Far Cry titles after that follow a generalized formula, right? Those were, first of all, that's what I was talking about. Second of all, even though I've never had a chance to properly play Far Cry 2, I think it looks ugly as hell. Even though people say it looks great, it's way too dull in color for me. In the sense that, like, if you look at this, look at how colorful and vibrant this is, right? You got this beautiful blue water. And when you look at the sand, that's vibrant sand, right? That's not just dull-ass color, and there's nice contrast. It doesn't look like that in Far Cry 2 without mods. Use mods, it looks great. Without the mods, it looks like shit. When I said desert, I meant kind of like the Mad Max 2015 game desert, where the desert is super vibrant. But you know it's a desert. You know, it looks like a desert, feels like a desert, sounds like a desert, but somehow they make it look ridiculously good. So that's the kind of thing I would like to see in Far Cry, honestly. Okay. We got a little bit of it, like, with the Mars DLC. Like, remember that, how sandy that was? That's the kind of thing I would like to see in an actual game. Okay, now this... isn't the best position to be stuck in. That didn't last. Okay, let's grab our shit and get the fuck out. We got springs to collect. Good, yeah, and these things are not something I want to pass up because they give us a lot of stuff. I would probably also like to get the MP40 before we get the AK-47, honestly, because the AK-47 is going to be a lot of fun for me to use, because I pretty much used that 100% constantly in the previous game, Far Cry 5, I mean. Oh, shit, Nugget. Bring it. Bear, it looks like. No, that's a Wolverine. Yeah, I guess, yeah, that is a Wolverine. Looks kind of like a bear. Ooh! So there's supposed to be springage here. Old urinal. You're gonna stay in this bus. Is there a skeleton in here? Yeah, my dude, I'd miss the internet too. There's a boot. Is this a reference to something? The Scarecrow, the boot? Okay. I didn't want him, like, looting my frickin' vehicle up there. Because that shit's fucking happened in other Far Cry games. You go up to meet an NPC, you get out of your car, talk to them, and then they run and get in your car and drive off. Like assholes. Cinder block. Well, there's supposed to be another spring here.
You know it.
Well, there's a spring right there attached or on top of the bus. There we go. Good.